Say, we need the Lord. We need Him in every aspect of our life. I know there's trouble everywhere, but let me tell you something. You can rest assured that God is still there. And He's just waiting for us to come to Him. The Word of God say, man ought to always pray. And not faint. And let me say this, it ought not to take a tragedy to get us to call on our God. We ought to always be talking to our God. So we invite you from wherever you are to come to the altar. Bring God your problems. Bring Him your concerns. Say He's able to handle them.
Father, when the world tried to swallow us up, Father, it was you.
Lord, it was you that provided salvation.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Through your Son, Jesus Christ. Lord, we thank you.
Thank you, dear Lord.
And even right now, Father God, somebody is crying. But Lord, we thank you, Father God, because, Lord, you made everything all right with us. Lord, as we come, Father God, we know that there are some, Father, who've yet to try. Lord, they're frustrated.
All right, all right.
Father, some are aggravated. Some have been humiliated. But Lord, we come to you, Lord, because we know, Father God, that you are our only help.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Father, you can fix those things that's wrong in our lives.
That's right.
Father, you can open doors that's been closed in our face.
Yes.
Father, you can make a way out of no way. Father, those who have gone weak, Father God, because of time, Father, we know you can give them strength.
All right, all right.
And Master, we come to you, Father, because, Lord, we tried everything else.
Yes, sir.
And Father, only to see, Father, we still have problems.
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
Father, we still have broken hearts.
Yes.
But Master, when we come to you, Father, we know you're able.
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
To heal our broken hearts.
Yes, sir.
You're able to solve our problems.
Yes, sir.
Now, Lord, I pray this morning that you will keep your eyes upon us.
Please, Lord Jesus.
All over America, Father God, somebody is asking us, what is going on in our world? But Lord, I thank you because, Lord, I know that you're still in control.
Yes, sir.
Because you can speak, Lord.
Yes.
And things will change.
Yes, sir.
Lord, you told us if we call on your name.
All right, all right.
And Lord, we are sincere in our call. You said you'll come by and see about us.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
Now, Lord, here
now.
We are.
Yes.
Our Father, somebody troubled in mind. We can't make it without you being in our life.
Yes, sir.
Lord, we need you right now.
Right now, Lord.
Father, somebody's the mind is all messed up.
Yes, yes.
Because of the recent events. Lord, let them know that you're the same God.
Yes, yes.
The body of Israel out of Egypt.
Yes.
You're the same God. That gave us life.
All right, all right.
Lord, we can trust in you to keep us. Lord, we lift up our sick before you. Lord, I pray, Father, that you would touch bodies. Touch minds.
Please, Lord.
Lord, that you would heal like only you can.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Father, we bring those before you, Father God, who time have seen to sap all their strength. Father, we ask you, Father, to strengthen them.
Please, Lord Jesus.
Those who have been torn down, Lord, build them up like only you can. Master, we pray for a word from you. Father, we need you this morning. Father, we need you this morning. Father, I pray for your presence in this house.
In this house, Lord.
Lord, I pray for your presence in this house. Father, let your spirit move among your people. Father, I pray for our children.
Yes.
Father, I pray, Master, that we will leave them something that will be worth hanging on to.
Yes.
Lord, I pray that you will protect them.
Yes.
I pray that you will cover them.
Yes. Yes.
Lord, I pray that you will keep them. Just speak to us this morning. Father, we pray this prayer for your people. We lift our voices to you in expectancy of you to take control and to get involved in our situation. Oh, we bless you now. We lift you up. Father, we pray your blessings upon all these your people. Father, you know the questions in their minds, the questions in their heart, the concerns that they have. Lord, fix it.
Please, Lord Jesus.
Like only you can.
Yes, yes.
Well, Master, this is our prayer.
Our prayer, Lord.
Lord, this is our praise.
Our prayer.
Well, it's in the holy name of Jesus.
Name of Jesus.
Master, we pray and we thank you for it.
Thank you, Jesus.
That all the people of God say, thank you, Master.
Thank you, Master.
Thank you, Master.
Thank you, Master.
Thank you,
Master.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Yeah. the Lord.
We sure do need him now.
We sure do need him now.
Bless the name of the Lord. Give glory to God our Father.
All right, all right.
Ask you to turn with me to a very familiar passage of scriptures, and one that we need to hear right now. Ask you to look in the book of 2 Chronicles. Any of you know about where I'm going? 2 Chronicles, chapter number 7.
Since 9-1-1, let's
facing, many of us have let our guards down and have been lulled into a state of denial and complacency that the tragic events that were taking place all around us meant very little to us. Because for some reason we have felt somehow or another that we were exempt from this type of behavior and actions until last Thursday. Many of us have gone, we went about life as usual until devastation, destruction, and the shedding of innocent blood finally landed at our doorsteps. My question this morning, why does it take a crisis or an act of violence or destruction to get a nation of people to turn back to or even acknowledge that we need God? Understand, this is a nation that boasts, that have proclaimed that we are a nation built on religious principles.
Right.
But then why does it take something as heinous, amen, as the things that took place on this week to finally shake us and arouse us and make us come to the conclusion, amen, make us admit that we need God? Yes. Why is it that young black men have to die in our streets at the hands of those that are sworn to protect and to serve them, and then innocent and good civil servant lives are suddenly snuffed out by someone that they are protecting and serving, who have allowed Satan to mess with their mind and cloud their judgment, to think that he himself can set the order straight by rendering evil for evil? I wonder, why does it take that for us to realize how much we need the Lord? I know someone want to classify this as an act of terrorism, but I truly believe that these are evil acts.
All right.
Brought about by the presence of sin that has polluted our land.
Yeah,
we can pass it off, we can gloss over it, amen. And we can even look for, amen, somebody to point a finger at to say they are responsible for it. Amen. We can call it terrorism as if we want to, but let me tell you what it really is. These are really acts that have been perpetuated by sin.
All right.
No. Those two black men didn't deserve the fate that was responsible for ending their lives. Neither did these four police officers whose lives were suddenly taken away, who had nothing to do with what took place in Louisiana and Minnesota. Amen. They wanted to go home just like everybody else.
All right.
But these were acts, I believe, that resulted from the presence of the free reign of sin in the mind and the heart of mankind that only produces evil works. Let me tell you, Satan's desire is to turn mothers against daughters,
All right.
Fathers against sons, blacks against whites, amen, and all mankind against God, amen. And he does it, amen, through evil works. Yes. He does it through appealing to man's desire for fortune and fame over faith and family, amen. As a nation, oh my God, as a nationality of people, amen. The black man, amen. For so long in our life, amen, we held on to faith and fame.
All right.
Amen. That was the one thing that kept us, amen, was our faith and our family. Amen. Our faith in God, amen, and our family, amen, it kept us all the way through slavery.
Yes, it did.
Oh, come on.
Satan somehow, amen, had infiltrated our way of thinking. Amen, infiltrated, amen. He had somehow arrested the attentions of our desires. Amen, and many of us, amen, who once trusted in faith and family. Now we are selling out faith and family for fortune and for fame. And because of this, and now our world is sick with the prevailing nature and activity of sin that has infested our land. No wonder why these tragic events take place in a country that's built on religious principles. It's simply because, amen, we've gotten away from what's kept us down through the years. We've gotten away from what held us up when others try to press us down. Yes, I come by to tell you, our land is sick because the people of our land are sick.
All right.
Come by to tell you, yes, we are enduring some things, we're seeing some things that we've never seen before. Amen. And we're wondering, how bad will it get? But I come by to tell you, that is a remedy for the ills of the world.
All right, all right.
And that remedy is rest with God.
Yes.
Yes, there is an answer to the problems of the world that God has entrusted with those who are called by His name.
Yes.
Yes, there is an answer to the questions that many have asked all week long. Wonder what happened or what could have made them to react like that. And let me tell you, our answer is not in our president. Our answer is not in our Congress. Our answer is not in our Senate. Our answer won't come from our House of Representatives. Amen. Because what we have that is troubling the world right now, we have a problem with a world that is full of the sickness of sin. And I come by to tell you, the president can't deal with sin. The Congress, amen, they can't pass a bill, amen, that will, amen, that will turn around the fortune and the work of sin. Amen. Our Senate can't devise laws that can control sin. Amen. The only help that we have, amen, in getting our world back together is that we must first go back to the one who has created us and who knows all about us. We have to go to the one that can deal with the sin problem. Yeah. They make laws. Amen. They make laws and they make rules. Amen. But let me tell you what laws and rules will do. They're only dealing with the symptoms of what's really the problem in our land.
All right.
ever since the fall in the garden.
All right.
Yes, you can have all the rallies you want to, but until we get back to our God, we will still be affected by the infestation of sin in our society. Until we turn back to God.
All right, all right.
There will still be mothers with broken hearts.
All right.
Crying because their son or daughter won't come home tonight. Until we get back to God, there will still be families falling apart.
All right.
There will still be troubles in our streets.
All right, all right.
There will still be violence.
Yes.
Among the people. Yes, there will still be days where brothers will hunt down brothers. There will still be days when fathers will turn against sons. And mothers against their daughters. I tell you, we're in a sin land. And our only help will come from the Lord. Yes, you wonder why these things are going on. They're going on because we've drifted further and further away from God.
All right.
There was a day, there was a time where we used to desire to walk with the Lord.
Yes.
Now, we only acknowledge God when there's a crisis.
All right,
that lands at our door.
All right.
There was a day and a time where we didn't mind calling on the name of the Lord. Because we're seeing things that we never thought we would see in our life.
If they would just humble themselves.
I told you earlier, that was a time in our life where we used to seek the Lord.
All right.
But now everybody's trying to be popular.
Come on now, come on.
There was a day where we used to consult the Lord. Now everybody trying to write a how-to book. But I come by to tell you, the only way we gonna make it is if we learn to seek the Lord. And that's the only way that we're gonna get through. If we learn to seek the Lord. And David said, seek his face forevermore.
Oh.
Just a little bit closer. James said, if you draw nigh to him,
He'll draw nigh unto you. We need to get close to the Lord. Amen. We need to pray. We have an awesome responsibility. Amen. We can't wait to work, but we need to be working while we're waiting on the Lord. That work is to do what? To reach lost humanity. He told you, he said, you will be a light to this world. We need to let our light shine in the world. God bless you. May the Lord keep you. There may be somebody that want to, amen, give their life to the Master. This is your opportunity to accept Him to be the Lord of your life. Tell you, God will save you. But you have the desire, you have to come to Him. Not only salvation is available, but rededication, repentance, and rededication is available. There may be somebody that wants to come back and tell the Lord, Lord, wait a minute, I haven't been doing all that I should. I know I'm one of your children, but I have not done the things that you told me to do. Lord, this day, right now, I want to get it right. I want to be an instrument of your service that you can trust me. This is your opportunity to come to Him. Let Him speak to your heart. Let Him speak to your life. Let Him change you. Yeah. I know I'm messed up. I know I've been messed up. Amen. We all are messed up, but let me tell you something, that we have a God that can fix anything that's messed up. And the thing that I like about it, He can take that old messed up thing and make it brand new. But you got to trust Him. You got to surrender to Him. He's not going to knock your door down to come into your life. He said, I'm just going to stand and I'm going to knock. It's up to you to let me in. Come today.
I really want to know.
what you've done, not what you know, but the final analysis rests upon, are you saved? Are you saved? Now God bless you. May the Lord keep you, is our prayer. Get Sister Cunningham, who will be going to get a man test done on her. Let's lift her up in prayer, amen, that God will cover her. Amen. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Master, how we bless you, man. How we glory you, man. Lord, how we thank you. Father God, we thank you, Father God, for what some may say, the good and the bad. But Lord, all of it, keep us, Father God, keep us in tune with how much, Father God, we need you in our lives. Master, we pray, Father God, that you would bless each and every one of these, your children. Father, bless their going out, bless their coming in. Father, I pray for their families, Father, their communities, Father God, that you would cover them and keep us all, Father God, that, Lord, we would tell others about this great God that we serve, who watches over this whole world day and night. Lord, we pray your blessings upon all these, your children. We pray, Father God, that you will keep them in your mighty hand. And now may the grace of our Lord, the sweet communion of his Holy Spirit, we pray that it would rest, rule, and abide with us now and forevermore. Let us all